Hello and welcome to Indianomics. Earlier this month, a US company offered to supply power at 4.63 rupees to the state of Andhra Pradesh. This event signals that solar power has now become nearly competitive with thermal or coal-based power. If power can be generated on our rooftops and that too competitively, are we entering a brave new world where power will be available minus the political and the grid problems that accompany grid power? I have with me three gentlemen to discuss this issue: the Secretary of the Central Ministry of Renewable Power, Mr. Upendra Tripathi, Mr. Arvind Kumar, the MD Secretary of the State of Telangana, and Mr. Sumant Sinha, Chairman and CEO of ReNew Power, a company which delivers solar and wind power solutions. But before we get to our guests, hear out a few facts. On November 4th, Sun Edison, a US company, successfully bid to supply solar power to Andhra state at 4.63 rupees per unit. Actually, 9 of the 28 companies that participated bid to supply power below 5 rupees. This compares with bids of 11 to 13 rupees that one unit of solar power cost in FY11. Globally, solar power costs have fallen by 200 times, from $100 per watt in 1975 to 50 cents per watt this year. Analysts estimate costs may fall another 50% by 2020. Tony Seba, scholar on disruption and clean energy from Stanford University, estimates solar power has achieved grid parity in hundreds of markets and will achieve 80% parity globally by 2017. Costs of storage of energy have also been crashing at the rate of 16% per year since 2010. Tesla, Foxconn and LG Chem are rapidly setting up battery factories. Tony Seba again estimates storage costs may fall to $1.2 per day by 2020. Are we therefore reaching a stage when power will be generated and stored on our rooftops or in our neighborhood, and the average consumer will no longer be dependent on the politician and the babu for a power connection? That's the question we are asking. And my guests, once again, let me introduce them, are the Secretary of the Central Ministry of Renewable Power, Mr. Upendra Tripathi, Arvind Kumar, Energy Secretary, Telangana State, and Sumant Sinha, Chairman and CEO of ReNew Power, a company which delivers solar and wind power solutions. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining me, and I hope at the end of the discussion we'll be ushered into the brave new world of solar energy generated on our rooftops. But first, some jargon needs to be cleared. Sumant, you as the industry expert, we are talking of two different sets of power, is it? Solar power which is generated in farms and that supplies to the grid, and solar power generated by PV cells on our own rooftops. Both of them cost have come down below 5 rupees per unit?
No, Lata, I would not exactly say that. I think even the recent bid that you alluded to, I think, is far below where the market actually is at. I would think that the proper pricing of solar power is still well in excess of 5 rupees. If you properly cost all the risks of forex, of execution, and so on. And therefore, you know, 4.63 is an indicator. I think in general that solar costs are going down, but I would not say it's come down to that level. So that is point number one as far as where the ground-mounted utility-scale solar is at. If you look at rooftop solar pricing is just a little bit higher than where the ground-mounted solar is at. And that, in fact, is in one way the beauty of solar, that even if you come up with much smaller size installations, the cost does not go up that dramatically as it might have otherwise. And so if I look at the rooftop installations, the costs today are probably in the range of 6 rupees to 6 rupees 50 paise per, let's say, per rooftop installation. And of course, it depends upon the size and the nature of the roof and the orientation of the roof and so on. But I would say that if you ask me honestly, I think ground-mounted solar is probably at about 550, 570, and rooftop solar is probably at the 625 to 650 level, is where the pricing, the proper pricing with proper returns with long-term sustainable business models really would be at this point in time.
Okay. That's the cost now. But Sumant, we know that in the last 5 years, costs have fallen from something like 11, 12 rupees per unit to even that 5, 550 that you are saying now. If you have to draw the graph further down to 2018 or 20, where will the cost go?
So I certainly think, Lata, we are sitting on a sort of reducing cost curve. I think that in the earlier part, a lot of the cost reduction came because there's oversupply on the panel manufacturing side globally. And so cost crashed as a result of that. I think now we're at a point where demand and supply are relatively balanced, and therefore prices have more or less stabilized. I think from here on, we're going to see price reductions happening mostly because of technology improvements, of which there still will be quite a bit. And so if you ask me, I believe that solar costs will keep reducing, maybe at the rate of 2 to 4% every year. And if you extrapolate that over, let's say, a 10-year time period, then it is very conceivable that solar costs might very well go down by at least 30-40% from where we are right now. And I think that is quite possible, given the nature of the manufacturing efficiencies, the technology research that is going on. So from that standpoint, you could argue that solar costs, you know, let's say 10 years out, could be at about 350 to 4 rupees as well, okay, in today's rupee terms. Okay. And that, I think, is really where the transformational power of solar really comes in.
Okay. Well, let me get the secretary from the Central Minister of Renewable Power. Mr. Tripathi, what is it that your consultants and your experience are telling you? Are they telling you that we have to wait for 15 years, or given the governmental push that, you know, 100,000 megawatts should be generated through solar power before 2020, given this kind of a government support, do you think we will advance this date?
Well, Lata, what our consultants, some of them tell us, apart from the roadmap for 100,000 megawatt, which is a world record by 2022, you know, two things that we actually miss in this debate about, you know, grid parity, the price and cost. Now, what is hidden behind this solar energy is the type of input we use and the future input costs. It is free, it is usable, and the second thing is the impact on environment. For example, every 1 megawatt of solar that we put, either on the roof or ground mounted, there are 50 vehicles which are going off the road. And in places like Delhi and all that, where the, you know, the quality of air is bad, it means a lot.
All right. No, I take your point. Are you getting a sense that costs can fall faster? What are your consultants telling you? Will we see the bids go down from 5 to below 5?
Yes. Because, you know, the cost is a function of volume. Cost is a function of your capital cost. And cost is a function of where you are locating your solar plants. It is not uniform all over the country or all over the world. In some places, if the cost of capital is low and the solar resource quality is high and the scale is big, you will get, the prices will come down. And you correctly pointed out that the, you know, cost of storage is going down, the cost of panels is going down, and there are R&D, very exciting R&D things are happening. If you get panels much more efficient than what you have today, suppose with nanoparticle or non-silicon based materials, the cost may further go down. So it is an exciting world to come, yes.
Fair enough. Arvind Kumar, what has been the experience? Your neighboring state of Andhra Pradesh was the one that set this record, at least an India record, of getting a bid at 4.63 paise per unit. Are you likely to prefer solar over, or at least renewable power over non-renewable?
I must say we are in very exciting times, because as you mentioned that in Andhra Pradesh, the bid floated by NTPC got a record price of 4.63. Let me explain. Primarily because it was in a solar park, so it's at one location where land is provided, and then it goes directly onto the grid. So the problems associated with land acquisition and other problems were not there, and that's why this price could be achieved. Secondly, the process of bidding, which was followed by Ministry of Power, was unique in the sense that it was put online. All bidders could see the lowest price, and they kept kind of calibrating their price accordingly. So this is a new method, and I guess it's going to be the future. In Telangana, last 6 months, we have finalized two bids totaling about 2,500 megawatt. And I must say, in a year's time, last year our rate was 6 rupee 45 paisa per unit. And this year, in the latest bid of 2000, the lowest rate quoted is 5 rupee 17 paisa. So we have already seen a decline of about 1 rupee 60 paisa just in a year's time. And now the challenge for us is to build transmission lines in accordance with the solar generation which is taking place. Because unlike thermal, solar generation can take place in a year's time, whereas if we want to add transmission line accordingly, that takes about 18 months to 2 years. So that's our challenge, that we need to build infrastructure to take care of solar generation. When I talk about Telangana, we have gone for reverse bidding where land is to be acquired by private bidders. So what we have done is in our solar policy, which was introduced in June this year, we have provided certain enabling clauses, things like any land which where solar generation is being set up is exempted under Land Ceiling Act. There is automatic deemed conversion to non-agriculture usage. They can apply in the single window clearance. So what I'm trying to say, earlier they used to take about 8 months to 1 year time for getting all clearances. Now they can get within a span of 1 month. So this extra 11 months, they save on their cost, working capital, interest. So all this adds up to lowering the cost.
Fair point. Well, I have to take a break on that note, but I'm going to come back to all my three guests and ask them what other kind of government incentives at the municipal level or at the state level or at the central level can be arranged to ensure that solar power becomes even more competitive. Back in a minute. Welcome back to Indianomics. We've been discussing whether solar power can become as common as the cell phone, actually. My guests are the Secretary in the Central Ministry of Renewable Power, Mr. Upinder Tripathi, Sumant Sinha, the CEO and Chairman of Renew Power, a company that offers wind and solar solutions, and Mr. Arvind Kumar, the Energy Secretary of the State of Telangana. Sumant, when you set up solar panels in buildings, technically even the windows and doors can be made of PV cells. Is there something that municipalities can do in terms of offering incentives for new construction or buildings to get into solar power, or disincentivize people from depending on the grid?
I think today we don't have any transparent solar panels. And so you can't really install solar panels on windows and generate power from that. I think that will happen at some point in the future. I'm sure somebody is already researching that area, and we'll probably start having full glass facades coming out of solar panels, and that will, I think, also have its own sort of revolution. As far as the current opportunities are concerned, you can actually put solar panels only on rooftops, provided that the facing and so on is right. But the problem is the cost that most residential customers pay in India for their power is a little bit subsidized, and so they're paying typically 3 rupees to 4 rupees, 450. And as I said earlier, the cost of installing a solar rooftop for residential customers is about 650 or thereabouts. So the economic viability for residential customers is not yet there. It will come about, I think, in the next, let's say, 2-3 years' time. And the question is, what can the government do right now to incentivize and bridge this gap? So one of the things I think the government can very easily do is that if somebody installs a solar panel and spends, let's say, 5 lakh or 10 lakh rupees doing that, perhaps the government can give that person an income tax break on that money. And that itself will, for example, reduce the cost of that solar capex by 30%, right, at the marginal tax rate. And that will then immediately bridge that gap and immediately lead to much more installation of solar panels. The second thing is that you need to have net metering, because in the daytime, in the peak time, I may produce more power than I actually consume, because I may be at work, my kids may be in school, etc. In which case, I need to be able to feed that extra power into the grid, and therefore I need to have a net metering system where if I feed power into the grid actually pays me for the excess power that I supply into it. So that's the second thing that is happening, but certainly those policies have to come into some better alignment so that it becomes more economically viable. And the third thing that needs to happen really in terms of doing all of this is that certain business models have to come into play, such that there are many installers that set up. So just like you have people who come in and set up ACs in your house, you need to have a whole ecosystem of people who can just come in and set up solar panels in your house. And then that ecosystem will start developing and will start getting financed as well.
Well, Mr. Tripathi, what can be tax incentives that the government is already thinking can contemplate to make both solar parks as well as rooftop solar power generation more viable?
Yes, Latha, in fact, out of 100,000 megawatt, 40,000 megawatt by 2022 we are planning to bring on the rooftop. Because number one, it doesn't require new transmission lines to be built. There is no transmission loss in the rooftop because it's very close to the grid. And number three, it is also, you know, more green power. It is a tax-free income type. There is no transmission loss. Now, you know, just take the example of Delhi Metro, for example. They have gone in a very large way for rooftop. It is because, you know, prior to having rooftop, they are paying around 9 rupees for electricity per unit. Now they have got for 6 rupees per unit. And that is why they are planning to put 500 megawatt even outside and bring their solar power into Delhi. Now, in rooftops, if you go to other areas, we have around 60 cities, you know, which where we give a lot of emphasis to rooftop. There are 16 states almost now who have brought in the net metering rules. For example, in Karnataka, if you have a rooftop solar and you sell it to the grid, you know, you will get 9 rupees per unit, which is much more than what you pay. And in Gurgaon, for example, they have brought a rule that, you know, any new house you build beyond a size, the rooftop is compulsory. And we have written to most of the state governments to make some clause where both incentive in terms of, you know, electricity tax reduction or disincentive in terms of compulsion will be put in. And most states have been very progressive in this. Some are giving new FAR for solar tops. And we find that a lot of demand is coming for rooftop, not only, you know, because they have they save cost, but also it helps in stabilizing the nearby grid. And it helps when there is outages in schools, in hostels. In terms of tax incentives, yes. Now, number one, the Ministry of Finance has issued a circular to all the banks that whenever they take rooftop, this loan for rooftop will be a part of the housing loan if it is a new house. And if it is an old house, it will be a home improvement loan. It will come under priority sector lending, and the interest rate will be less, like the home loan. And this apart from bringing the priority sector, all the banks are now requesting to earmark a particular, you know, percentage of their credit, which will be earmarked towards popularizing rooftop and solar. That apart, we are also going from state to state,
okay,
creating an awareness about the environmental benefit of rooftop.
Mr. Tripathi, actually, since
all these things put together.
Yes, since the state representative is already here, let me ask the Energy Secretary to wind up this discussion. What's looking like Telangana can offer and make solar power more attractive?
On the solar rooftop, I must admit that we have gone ahead, and as Sumant said, that new models are to be worked out. So in phase one, we have surveyed all government buildings and PSUs in Hyderabad city, and we have got an area of about 5 million square SFT, which we are going ahead in reverse bidding model. So idea is to make it attractive for the bidder also to put solar rooftop. So instead of individual households putting where cost economics often doesn't work out, we have compiled all the available rooftop under government buildings into one single bid, and we are going ahead with 5 million square feet of solar rooftop, and we are likely to get very good rates. So it's being worked out and bid will be out very soon. Second point I just want to mention here is that various DISCOMs, distribution companies, there has to be a model which is acceptable to them, because what's happening is the moment individual rooftop owner gets a solar rooftop at a cost lower than what he is paying, he wants to shift to solar rooftop. Whereas DISCOM, they are losing their prime customers, which often cross-subsidizes their low-cost customers. So there has to be a model which is workable, which is acceptable, and then in the long run, that's where the solution lies. And I think solar rooftop in Hyderabad, after phase one of government buildings, next phase, depending upon the rate which we are getting, we'll be targeting private institution, and third phase will be private individual rooftops, where we are saying, please give us your rooftop, we'll go for a single bidding where rates will come down, and under net metering, they will ultimately benefit.
Okay, Mr. Tripathi, Mr. Arvind Kumar, Sumant, thank you very much for joining me in this discussion. Well, Sumant began this discussion by telling us that 4.63 is not yet the most viable cost, that it is an ambitious costing of solar power. But he added, caveated it by saying that perhaps in the next 10 years, we are going to see the costs fall by probably 30 to 40%, and at that time, solar power will be way more competitive than non-renewable power. The two bureaucrats we have with us have given us a string of tax incentives and commercial incentives that will make solar power way more ubiquitously available and more cheaply available across cities. It looks like 10 years from now, we will be talking about the rooftop solar, taking it for granted like we take the mobile phone for granted today. And if that will mean a time when politicians no longer will be able to attract votes by offering cheap power, when theft of power from the grid will not be a reality, it does look like 10 years down the line, electricity in India is in for some very, very good times, sir. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me in this conversation.